भुवनेश्वरम सेबो नॉन ऑफ स्टेशन भुवनेश्वरम If you are not responding, then you will get absent. So kindly answer fast. Bhuvaneshwaran, give the answers on non-August iteration what we have discussed. Roja raised the hand. Can you answer? Roja.
Ma'am, analytic substance dissolved in solvent which does not contain water, ma'am.
Okay. What other things we have discussed?
Theory, ma'am.
What?
Types of solvent.
Okay.
Four types of solvent, ma'am.
Yeah.
Aprotic solvents, protophilic solvents, protogenic solvents, amphiprotic solvents.
Okay. Good. So regarding solvents and what is non-aqueous titration theory behind it, we have discussed. Good, Roja. Bhuvaneshwaran, can you explain now? Mr. Bhuvaneshwaran.
Ma'am?
Yeah, say, give the answers on non-aqueous titration theory, types of solvents, and definition on that. Shall I put an accent? You should have listened to her, no? She already said, right? Name some solvents used for non-aqueous titration. Why we need to prefer non-aqueous titration? Don't know anything. You have not understood from anything from non-aqueous titration. What?
Well, non-aqueous titration refers type of titration, man.
Okay. Is the type of titration all means all the people know that?
Analyte substance dissolved in a solvent. Okay. Does not contain water.
Okay. Good.
And this procedure very important pharmacological assessment.
Okay. In next slide also you can read.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, pa, thank you. Anybody else would like to say about non-aqueous titration? Okay, now let's move on to, thank you Roja and Bhuvaneshwaran for your answers. Now let's move on to the remaining topics of non-aqueous titration method. So non-aqueous titration meant for titration of substances without water. So what type of substances require non-aqueous method? Weak base and weak acid substances. Weak base and weak acid. And what purpose we are doing non-aqueous titration? Since water can behave as a both weak acid and weak base, it will interfere in the endpoint detection and even in the titration of weak acids and weak bases. That's why in order to get an accurate endpoint of titration, we need to go with non-aqueous method. Means removal of water from the titration itself we need to carry out to conduct the non-aqueous titration method. Okay, no single water molecule should exist in during the titration. If it exists also, some percentage is the 0.05% water only can exist during the titration. all water molecules should be removed in order to get accurate endpoint in non-aqueous method. And there are four types of solvents: aprotic, protophilic, protogenic, and amphiprotic. And one more type of solvent also is there based on this leveling effect. The solvents are called leveling solvents that we will discuss after completing the other parts of non-aqueous titration method. Leveling solvents. What are leveling solvents means? This protophilic and protogenic solvents. If protophilic solvent, what is ammonia and pyridine, if it is added to the weak acid, then that weak acid will act as strong acid. Means their capacity will be, acidic capacity will be increased in presence of protophilic solvent. So that is called leveling effect for protophilic solvents. And the solvents are called leveling solvents also. Like protogenic solvents, when it is present with weak base, okay, so they have leveling effect on the bases. This point note down. So when this acid, strong acids, that is protogenic solvent, sulfuric acid and acetic acid, is present with weak base, then the weak base will act as strong base. Okay, so this particular category of solvents are called as leveling solvents. Okay, and sulfuric acid and acetic acid are leveling solvents for weak bases. Okay, protogenic solvents are leveling solvents for weak bases, where protophilic solvents are leveling solvents for weak acids. Okay, weak acids, they are leveling solvents since they will increase the acidity of weak acids. Likewise, protogenic will be increasing the leveling effect of weak bases. So these two solvents are called as leveling solvents. So this lies under fifth category. Commonly four categories based on the leveling effect of solvents. There is another category called leveling solvents due to leveling effect. What is leveling effect? It is important 2-mark question. What is leveling effect means? When the solvents exist with, if weak acid or weak base, your substance may be, if the protophilic solvents, protophilic means what? It will be accepting proton. From where it will be accepting proton? The solvents from acids. So these solvents, protophilic solvents, when it is added with weak acid substance, solvents used to dissolve the substance, that is acid, then this acid, due to the property of protophilic solvents, it acts as strong acid. The acidic character of weak acids will be increased. Before that it was weak. Now in presence of protophilic solvents, the acidity is increased. Okay, so this type of effect is called leveling effect. That means it makes the weak acid to become strong acid. So that effect is called leveling effect. Then the solvents are called leveling solvents. So what is the example of leveling solvent? Protophilic solvents and protogenic solvents. Protogenic solvents are acidic solvents, so they will donate proton to the bases. If weak bases are dissolved in protogenic solvents, this will accept the proton, weak bases, and these weak bases acts as strong base. Okay, in presence of protogenic solvents, so these weak bases and the effect is called leveling effect. Okay, so there are two categories, protophilic and protogenic solvents to act as leveling solvents. This is another category of types of solvents. So what are the types of solvents now? What are the types of solvents? Types of solvents are an important 5-mark question. So you have to read with example, okay? With reasons and with example you have to write. You can even make a tabular column of types of solvent. What is the mechanism of each solvent? What is an example? And give with an drug substance which is dissolved in that particular solvent. Okay, so that you will get full 5-mark for solvents used in non-aqueous titration. So what are the types of solvents? Can anyone summarize the solvents? Chitesh?
ma'am.
Say what are the types of solvents used in non-aqueous titration method?
Four types, ma'am. Aprolic solvent.
Aprotic. Aprotic. Aprotic means.
Aprotic solvent. Protophilic solvent. Protorganic solvent. And p-protic solvents.
Okay. What another category I told now?
Leveling solvents.
Leveling solvents. What are leveling solvents? Protophilic and protogenic solvents. There is amphiprotic solvents also are there. Another one, protogenic and protophilic will act as leveling solvent. Okay. Now let's move on to the next part of non-aqueous titration method, that is acidimetry and alkalimetric titration using non-aqueous titration method. What are acidimetric titration and alkalimetric titration in non-aqueous method? So it is also acid-base titration. So in that, acidimetry and alkalimetry are there. Let's discuss, since the two different categories are applicable widely in pharmaceutical drug substances analysis. Okay, so that we need to study the two categories separately: acidimetry in non-aqueous titration, alkalimetry in non-aqueous titration. So that is your second part of non-aqueous titration method. So what is acidimetry? Acidimetry name indicates if you titrate the substance with standard acid. If you titrate or assay the substance with standard acid, then the technique is called acidimetry. If the sample is titrated with standard base, then it is called alkalimetry. Got it? That means burette content, based on burette content, we are classifying acidimetry and alkalimetry. What is the burette content for acidimetry? What will be the burette content for acidimetry? None of you can answer. Even you can put message also. Okay. The chat box, you can put message also. What is burette content for acidimetry? Or you can unmute your mic and give answers also. Okay. What is the content for acidimetry?
Acid. Burette la vandu acid.
So standard acid is taken in standard base is taken in burette for alkalimetry. Okay. So what will be the titrate we'll be taking for acidimetry? Base then. Base. So if non-aqueous method, what will be there in acidimetry? Weak base. Got it? In non-aqueous method, titrate will be of weak base. Weak base will be titrated against standard acid. So acid will be of strong acid. Weak base versus strong acid will come in acidimetry. What will come? Weak base and strong acid. For alkalimetry, strong base will be the standard base. That is titrated, means used for titration of acidic substance. What is the nature of acidic substance? Weakly acidic. So for alkalimetry, weak acid is titrated against strong base. Standard base. Standard represents known concentration, where your substance is unknown concentration. So unknown concentration of weak base and weak acid are analyzed using acidimetry and alkalimetry in non-aqueous method. Got it? So what is acidimetry? It is the titration of weak base with standard acid. That will be strong acid. In alkalimetry, titration of weak acid with strong base, that is standard solution, is carried out. This is the difference between acidimetry and alkalimetry. What is acidimetry and what is alkalimetry in non-aqueous titration? So the second part what we are going to discuss is, after solvents, what are the things? Acidimetry and alkalimetry. What are the types of solvents we have discussed in non-aqueous method? Not in aqueous method, this is non-aqueous method. Aprotic solvents, protophilic solvents, protogenic solvents, amphiprotic and leveling solvents. Next to that, acidimetry and alkalimetry we are getting in. And what are acidimetry and alkalimetric titrations? Acidimetry means the titration is carried with acid, standard acid. As alkalimetry, it is carried with standard base. Alkali represents base, acidic represents acid. And it will be, what will be the titrate or analyte? Weak base here and here weak acid. For alkalimetry, weak acid. For acidimetry, weak base. Now let's move on to the first part of acidimetry. Acidimetry in non-aqueous titration. It has two classification. The titration by acidimetric method is followed for two categories. One is titration of primary, secondary and tertiary amines. So this will be of weak base. In acidimetry, what we are taking? Weak base versus strong acid. Standard acid is strong acid. Unknown concentration of weak base will be determined by acidimetry. Acidimetry is applicable for which substance? Weak base or weak acid? Which substance acidimetry is applicable?
Weak base.
Weak base. Weak base. That part you should be very clear. Okay. Weak base. So what are weak bases here then? Titration of, there are two class of weak bases we are going to titrate by using acidimetry. First part is titration of primary, secondary and tertiary amines. Amines are weak bases. So primary, secondary and tertiary amines. Second part will be titration of halogen acid salts of bases. These weak bases will exist with halogen acid salts. Means like some drugs with hydrochloride. Likewise, we'll be seeing examples. That time you will come to understand what are the drugs are carrying halogen acids. Halogens, what are halogens? Chloride, bromide, iodide, fluoride. These are halogens, right? So the weak bases will form salts with this halogen acids. Acids means hydrochloric acid, hydrobromic acid, hydrofluoric acid. Likewise, it will be with acid. So the weak base will be attached with acid and to form salt. Some category of drugs will be existing in salt form with this halogen acid. So that will be titrated as a second part of acidimetry in non-aqueous method. So non-aqueous acidimetric method is divided into two parts. Titration of primary, secondary and tertiary amines and titration of halogen acid salts of bases. Bases here represents weak bases. Okay. In order to increase the solubility of this weak bases, it will be attached with this halogen acid salts. Okay. For means of its biological activity to increase the solubility, the bases will be attached with halogen acid acids. Okay. So that it will be coming under separate category apart from primary, secondary and tertiary amines. Now let's move on to the first part, that is titration of primary, secondary and tertiary amines. So this is example general reaction for primary amine. HClO4 here. Okay. It is perchloric acid. In the image, it is given wrongly. Just note down HClO4. Here you can find ClO4 minus. The same here it should come. So primary amine or NH2 represents or represents the general group. Okay. That is attached with primary amine will react with perchloric acid. What is HClO4? O4, not Cl4, it is O4, okay, HClO4, that is perchloric acid. It donates, it is strong acid, it is weak base, which is weak base, primary amine, and this is strong acid to donate proton to the weak base. So when it is donated to proton to the weak base, this weak base will behave like what? Strong base. So that is the concept, right? And this forms ammonium ion and perchloride will be, chlorate ion will be eliminated. It is chlorate ion, ClO4 minus. Example of drug titrated with means perchloric acid is methyl dopa. This is the structure of methyl dopa, which contains primary amine. This will be reacted with perchloric acid HClO4 and it forms ammonium ion and chlorate ion is removed. This is an example of drug that is titrated with perchloric acid, methyl dopa. This is a dopamine reactive drug, okay, methyl dopa. So this drug is of weak base. So it is one of the pharmaceutical drug of weak base titrated with perchloric acid. So similarly, many pharmaceutical substances are weakly basic in nature, and those drugs will be titrated widely using non-aqueous titration method. So when comparing with aqueous acid base method, non-aqueous acid base method is very much useful for analyzing pharmaceutical drug substance. So this is an example of that. In acidimetry, we are going to titrate weak bases with strong acid. Strong acid is what? Perchloric acid. Non-aqueous means what is the titrant you are using? Perchloric acid. You must remember what is the titrant or standard solution used for non-aqueous method? Perchloric acid. It is very common titrant in non-aqueous method. So what is the titrant in non-aqueous method? Mainly for acidimetry. Acidimetry is most common. Okay, comparing with alkalimetry, acidimetry is most common to carry out the titration for weak bases. Since most of the drugs will be carrying this amino group, primary, secondary, or tertiary amine, so it will be very convenient to analyze by acidimetric non-aqueous method. Okay, so what is the titrant? One of you spell the titrant. Name of the titrant in non-aqueous method. Nobody is listening. Then
perchloric acid.
Perchloric acid. Okay, perchloric acid. Good. Perchloric acid. When it is used, it is, what is the nature of perchloric acid? Strong acid. What is the nature of perchloric acid? Strong acid. Okay, it is strong acid. Apart from hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid dissolved, perchloric acid is widely used. That you have to focus. So for non-aqueous titration, which method is preferred, or which acid is strong acid is preferred? Perchloric acid. It is very strong than hydrochloric acid and sulfuric acid, right? Mostly we'll be preferring hydrochloric acid for acid-based titration. So comparing hydrochloric acid, perchloric acid is strong. So that only weak bases could be titrated using, and the reactions will be stoichiometric, and that is equal. One molecule of perchloric acid is consumed with one molecule of drug substance. So it is stoichiometric reaction to get the accurate endpoint. And these are all different examples of drugs that is carried by acidimetric method, similar type of method, okay, using different indicators in non-aqueous method. So what are the indicators? Indicators we have not seen. So adrenaline, amino caproic acid, befinium, hydroxynaphthoate. So these are all weak bases. These are all drugs with weak basic in nature. So they will be titrated against perchloric acid. Here you can see the perchloric acid. So what known concentration is used? Perchloric acid. Here equivalent weight factor is given. 0.1 normal. What is the strength used? 0.1 normal. This is the strength of perchloric acid used for non-aqueous titration. So you can use the same tabular column for examples of drugs that is assayed by acidimetry. Okay. So what are the drugs? These are all the drug names, sample name. These are all the quantity of drug taken for the assay in gram wise. You can note down it is in gram wise, not in milligram or microgram. It is gram. For volumetric method, we require substance in gram wise. Then these are all the indicators used, various types of indicators in non-aqueous method. We are not using phenolphthalein, methyl red and all here. What are the indicators used for non-aqueous acidimetry? Crystal violet. Okay. For other two represents the same indicator, crystal violet. Then one naphthol benzene, one naphthol benzene. Methyl red, we cannot prefer much, but methyl red is the choice. Then crystal violet. Crystal violet is the common indicator for acidimetric assay. Apart from it, one naphthol benzene and voracet blue B. These indicators are used for non-aqueous acidimetry. Okay. And what is the titrant used? Perchloric acid. What is the strength used? Strength is most important. 0.1 normal. 0.1 normal perchloric acid is used. You have to learn how to prepare this 0.1 normal perchloric acid. In preparation and standardization of perchloric acid is important, and it will be 5-mark question. Okay, preparation and standardization of 0.1 normal perchloric acid. How you need to, there is a unique procedure for preparing perchloric acid without water molecule. Okay, so that the preparation procedure you have to learn, that I will be giving you. Even in practicals, you will be performing the non-aqueous titration with perchloric acid. Okay, so what are the indicators used? Crystal violet. Remember at least one indicator properly. For non-aqueous acidimetric assay, what is the indicator used? Acidimetry, crystal violet. What is the indicator? Crystal violet, not phenolphthalein. Okay, crystal violet. No methyl orange, no thymol blue. Don't just like spell the indicators. Okay, for non-aqueous titration, what indicator is used? Sudhir M. Rajan. Listen properly and give the answers. Okay. So what is the indicator?
Crystal violet.
Crystal violet. What other indicators are an option for using non-aqueous acidimetry? 1F benzene. Methyl red நீங்க அவ்வளவு எடுத்துக்க வேண்டாம். ஓகேவா? We are comparing methyl red only for one drug, we'll be using methyl red. Whereas other indicators are 1-naphthol benzene and voracet blue. 1-naphthol benzene and voracet blue. Commonly used indicator among these non-aqueous indicators, which is commonly used?
Crystal violet.
Crystal violet, okay. Crystal violet is commonly used. So these are all examples. You can quote minimum 10 examples during your means exams when it is asked. These are other category of examples using different indicators. You can see brilliant green, brilliant green, another quinaldine red, quinaldine red. This all can be used. Okay, methyl orange. Methyl orange, methyl red will not preferring much. Okay, will be preferring crystal violet. This is the common and accurate indicator for non-aqueous acidimetry. Whereas for some specific drugs, we'll be going with other indicators. Brilliant green, voracet blue, 1-naphthol benzene, quinaldine red, this all. So these are different non-aqueous indicators. Now let's see about the drug substance which is assayed by acidimetry using potentiometric deduction. These are using indicator. There are deduction methods are of two types: indicator deduction and potentiometric deduction. Indicator deduction and potentiometric deduction. And here indicators we have seen. For the nearly 32 drugs with indicators we have seen. So you can quote all the examples with each indicator. One example you can quote in the exams. Okay, with crystal violet, with 1-naphthol benzene, with methyl red, then voracet blue, then brilliant green, and then methyl orange. So with this each indicator, one example you can focus. Mostly Indian pharmacopoeia follows this non-aqueous titration method. Okay, these are all Indian pharmacopoeial procedures only. Okay, and this example, this tabular column represents the drugs which are assayed by potentiometry using the same titrant, perchloric acid titrant. Endpoint deduction alone is done with electrometric method, that is potentiometric method. Here for colchicine alone, 0.02 normal perchloric acid is preferred, whereas for other all other drugs, 0.1 normal perchloric acid is preferred. Okay, these are all the drugs assayed by acidimetry. Acidimetry using potentiometric titration. Okay. And next about titration of halogen acid salts of bases, weak bases. Halogen acids means hydrochloric acid will be attached with ammonia group. Some amine hydrochloride, likewise we'll be calling it. So ammonium ion and chloride ion will be released, and this chloride will be having interaction in during titration, and this will be masked by adding mercuric acetate. So the second step in this titration is we are using mercuric acetate, and which is not used in previous method. That is, titration of primary, secondary and tertiary amines will not use mercuric acetate. Since there the compound is merely amines, here it is attached with hydrochloride and it releases chloride ion. This ion will be having interaction, halides will be having interaction, so they cannot, see here you can see they cannot react quantitatively with acetous perchloride, so that it will be masked. Okay, in order to overcome this problem, mercuric acetate is usually added. This is mercuric acetate undissociated form, and this will be precipitating chloride as mercuric chloride. Okay, and what form we are getting? Acetate ion, and this acetate acts as strong base. It is strong base in acetic acid. Acetic acid, when it is in solution form, it will be existing as acetonium ion. This is acetonium ion, so it will react with acetate ion to give acetic acid. So acetic acid will be the solvent. Acetic acid, what type of solvent is it? It is protogenic solvent. It is the common solvent in acidimetric titration, so that acetonium ion converts acetate to acetic acid. So only acetic acid exists in the solution for analysis. No chloride or no mercury chloride will be involving or interacting with the titration of the drug molecule. So that mercuric acetate is used in the titration of halogen acids also bases. Got the point? Why the separate category of acidimetry we have classified? Since chloride ion halide will be eliminated or released from the reaction, it will be interacting with the titration of a drug molecule. So it will be masked or eliminated by using mercuric acetate. And mercuric acetate will be interacting with this and to form mercuric chloride. And acetate ion will be released. This acetate ion will be interacting with the solvated acetic acid, that is acetonium ion. Acetonium ion, and this will be interacting with acetic acid to give acetate to give four molecules of acetic acid. Got it? And in this picture here, no carbon will come here. Okay, CH3COOH2+. Acetonium ion. One proton will be added to acetic acid to form acetonium ion. Okay. And this will be converted to four molecules of, here two molecules of acetonium ion will interact with two molecules of acetate ion to give. This is a protogenic and this is protophilic. This is base and this is acid to give the acid. This is conjugated acid. It is conjugated acid and this is strong base to give weak acid. So these are some examples of hydrochlorides, halogen acid drugs titrated by using non-aqueous acidimetry. Amantadine hydrochloride, indicator employed here is a crystal violet, and 0.1 normal perchloric acid is preferred. For only clonidine hydrochloride, 0.5 normal perchloric acid is preferred. Only few cases we are changing the normality. Like here, only for colchicin, the normality is changed. Whereas common normality of perchloric acid is 0.1 normal. So if you learn how to prepare 0.1 normal perchloric acid, then it is easy to make other normalities. Okay. Then what other drugs? Chlorpromazine hydrochloride, clonidine hydrochloride, ciproheptadiene hydrochloride, dihydroimidine hydrochloride. So these are all the drugs. By using mercuric acetate, it will be titrated in the second category, what we have discussed. And what are the indicators used? Crystal violet, methyl orange, 1-naphthalbenzene, crystal violet. Commonly used will be crystal violet. And these are all some more examples using mercuric acetate. Okay, for all the drugs you can take with the different indicators, hydrochlorides, sulfates. You can take each halide one example, and you are going to read about ephedrine hydrochloride assay. Ephedrine hydrochloride assay, in brief, you are going to see according to your syllabus how ephedrine hydrochloride using acidimetric non-aqueous method is titrated. So in brief, you are going to see about that. Then these are all some more drugs. 33 drugs are assayed by using mercuric acetate in acidimetry. And one more drug also, sodium benzoate. Assay of sodium benzoate also you are going to see here itself. The quantity indicator used all mentioned here. So as per your syllabus, you are going to briefly read about how sodium benzoate, in what category it is assayed, acidimetric method using non-aqueous acidimetric, using indicator crystal violet it is assayed. The quantity of drug is 0.6 gram and each ml of 0.01 normal perchloric acid will be equivalent to this amount, 0.01441 gram of sodium benzoate. This is equivalent weight. For ephedrine hydrochloride, 0.5 gram drug is taken and the indicator will be of crystal violet only. Crystal violet continuing from here, crystal violet only. So commonly used indicator in lab is crystal violet. Okay, if you specifically require 1-aphthol benzene and quinaldin red, other indicators we could procure. Okay, crystal violet will be the common indicator, and here also 0.1 normal perchloric acid only is used, and 0.02017 gram of ephedrine hydrochloride is equivalent to 1 ml of perchloric acid, 0.1 normal perchloric acid. That is the equivalent weight factor. And these are all different various examples I have given, whichever you can remember, maximum 10 example you can quote for each class. Here 10 examples and here for indicators with the normal category, the first category, primary, secondary and tertiary amines, you can focus these many examples. 10 examples you can read and write for getting full mark. And some points to be considered during the titration of weak bases. One is titrant used. What is the titrant? Then preparation of 0.1 normal perchloric acid and its standardization. It is a sure 5-mark question you'll be getting. Then what type of solvent used? Here acetic acid will be the solvent. Then practical example of weak bases along with indicators you have to read. Indicators, what are the different types of indicators? Crystal violet, quinaldin red, brilliant green. Then our acid blue, these are all common indicators. This widely used will be crystal violet. Then typical example of weakly basic substances, the ephedrine hydrochloride. You have to read thoroughly how to assay ephedrine hydrochloride. The procedure also you can find in a table column, and brief procedure also it will give you. Okay, and next we'll move on to alkalimetry. So in acidimetry, what are the two categories we have discussed? An answer for this, no? What are the two categories in acidimetry we have discussed? Two category of drugs that is assayed by acidimetry. Give answers fast. Titration of primary, secondary, and tertiary amines. Then another category is what?
Halogen.
What?
Titration of halogen acid salts.
Halogen acid salts of bases. Example is ephedrine hydrochloride. For first category example is sodium benzoate. And what methyl dopa, that example what I have focused, can be written. And along with this, many examples also can be focused. 10 examples you have to read and write. Now let's move on to alkalimetry. This also contains two categories based on the titrant used. Okay, titration of weak acids. Here weak acids are titrated, where in acidimetry weak bases are titrated. Weak bases. Here weakly acidic substances are titrated. This is applicable for weak acids. So this will be titrated with strong base. Strong base means we'll be remembering sodium hydroxide only. So comparing sodium hydroxide, other bases also acts as strong. Even they are more strong than sodium hydroxide. So what are the strong bases? Sodium methoxide or lithium methoxide. Titration of weak acids with first category will be either sodium methoxide or using lithium methoxide. But the second category will be titration of weak acids with strong base like tertiary butyl ammonium hydroxide. tertiary butyl ammonium hydroxide. So what is the second category? Tertiary butyl ammonium hydroxide. So first category, let's see the example for first category, titration of weak acids with strong base like sodium methoxide or lithium methoxide. This is the example or a chemical structure of sodium methoxide. This is titrated with ethosuximide. This is weak acid. Ethosuximide is weak acid. Okay, it is considered as weak acid. Okay, and it is titrated with sodium methoxide. Since this formation of OH group donates proton, so it acts as weak acid. Just a minute. Weak acid. So sodium salt of ethosuximide is formed and methanol is released. This is about example of the first category, titrating with weak acid, strong base, weak acid with strong base. These are all different examples where the drug is weakly acidic drug is titrated with sodium methoxide or lithium methoxide. The normality will be 0.1 normal normality. For this case, alkalimetry, what are all the the indicators used? Means azo violet, thymol blue, quinaldine red, and thymol toluene. For alkalimetry, what are all the indicators? Thymol toluene, quinaldine red, thymol blue, azo violet. This will be only useful for alkalimetric non-aqueous titration. And the star represents potentiometric determination. Acetazolamide assay will be detected by potentiometry. So the first category will be assayed by potentiometric method. Endpoint will be detected by potentiometry, where others will be done with the indicators. Okay. So benzofluazide, allopurinol, mercaptopurine, all nalidixic acid. These are all important drugs. Of different pharmaceutical drugs of different pharmacological actions, they will be assayed by using non-aqueous alkalimetric method. Since they are acidic in nature, weakly acidic in nature, it will be assayed by non-aqueous alkalimetry using the indicators. What are the common indicators for alkalimetry? Quinaldine red. Quinaldine red we have seen for both acidimetry and alkalimetry, whereas thymol blue, azo violet, and thymol thalein, these indicators will be applicable for only alkalimetry. Okay. And what are all the titrants? Sodium methoxide or lithium methoxide. So you can read this examples. Next we'll see titration of weak acids with tertiary butyl ammonium hydroxide. Tertiary butyl ammonium hydroxide. This is tertiary butyl ammonium hydroxide. And example of drug, it is chlorthalidone. Chlorthalidone is titrated with tertiary butyl ammonium hydroxide to form this ammonium ion and water. This tertiary butyl ammonium ion and water is removed with the secondary amine group. At secondary amine group. This amide, amide is weak acid here then. So it forms a link with chlorthalidone, reacts with this N-butyl attached to secondary amine to form the salt. And what are the drugs assayed with the tertiary butyl, tetrabutyl ammonium hydroxide? It's not tertiary, it is tetrabutyl. We'll change it. Tetrabutyl. Tetra represents 4 butyl groups. Okay, 4 butyl groups. Tetra butyl. And here also we need to change tetra butyl. Tetra butyl ammonium hydroxide. Tertiary butyl, tetrabutyl ammonium hydroxide. Tetra represents 4 butyl groups. You can find here 4 butyl groups attached to the ammonium. Usually ammonium hydroxide will be used as a titrant. Instead of the protons, butyl group is added. So it is the strong base. Where ammonium hydroxide is weak base. When it is attached with butyl group, it becomes strong base. Okay. To titrate weak acid. Weak acid example here is chlorthalidone. Another examples are dialoxanide, furoate, fluorouracil, hydrochlorothiazide, niclosamide. These are all different drugs assayed by tetrabutyl ammonium hydroxide. Normality also 0.1 normal. So common normality what you have found for the assay of drugs, 0.1 normal. And thymol blue as indicator for fluorouracil, where other will be analyzed by potentiometric method. When you don't find indicators for detection, then you can go with potentiometric detection, instrumental detection, electrometric detection. Okay. Here, no matter whether you have indicator or not. If you have indicator, you can detect endpoint by indicator method. Then if you have instrument, then by potentiometry, we can detect the endpoint through graphical analysis. Okay. So this is about acidimetry and alkalimetry in non-aqueous method. And one more I would like to share with you about I will be sharing you another file. Can you see the estimation of sodium benzoate now?
Yes, ma'am.
So according to your syllabus, you have to read preparation, standardization and assay of sodium benzoate and ephedrine hydrochloride, these two drugs. Okay, for that procedure I am giving, according to the concept what we have discussed, it will be assayed by acidimetry, non-aqueous acidimetric method, both sodium benzoate, we have seen in the PPT, no? Sodium benzoate, it will come under the first category. Without mercuric acetate, will be titrating. Whereas ephedrine hydrochloride, by using mercuric acetate, it will be titrated. So both will cover under or come under acidimetric non-aqueous method. This is sodium benzoate, molecular weight, molecular formula, and description, how it appears. Then preparation of 0.1 normal perchloric acid. This is the standard solution, and standardization we have to do. Dissolve 8.5 ml of 72% perchloric acid in about 900 ml of glacial acetic acid. So solvent is glacial acetic acid with constant stirring. Add about 30 ml acetic anhydride. Why acetic anhydride here is added means if at all any water particle is present inside the solvent, it will be converted immediately to acetic acid. So what is the solvent must be? Acetic acid. In case water molecule is present, that water molecule will be interacting with acetic anhydride. It is highly reactive. So it will convert the water molecule to acetic acid. For that purpose, 30 ml of acetic anhydride is added. And we have to make the volume up to 1000 ml with glacial acetic acid. So, like water, here glacial acetic acid is the solvent. Okay, keep the mixture for 24 hours. Overnight we need to keep before assay. Before performing non-aqueous titration method, the previous day itself you have want to prepare perchloric acid and keep it for overnight. That is nearly 24 hours. Then acetic anhydride absorb. Why we have to keep it overnight means to allow acetic anhydride to absorb all the water molecule from perchloric acid. So that water will not interfere with the titration, so that we can get accurate endpoint. Okay. And it renders the solution virtually anhydrous. For that, we need to keep overnight. Then perchloric acid must be well diluted with glacial acetic acid before adding acetic anhydride. This point you have to note down. Perchloric acid must be well diluted with glacial acetic acid before acetic anhydride is added, because the reaction between perchloric acid and acetic anhydride is explosive. So after taking immediately perchloric acid, you cannot add acetic anhydride. You want to dilute perchloric acid with glacial acetic acid. Okay, since these two are explosive in nature. Okay. So that only the preparation of perchloric acid is unique, and you want to learn how to prepare and what is the quantity to be added. Okay, and how it is standardized? What is the primary standard used? That is potassium acid tolate. Okay, potassium acid tolate. Here also solvent is glacial acetic acid only. Crystal violet is the indicator. Okay, all things you want to know. And assay of sodium benzoate, 0.25 gram sodium benzoate is dissolved in 20 ml of anhydrous glycolic acid. Then we have to warm to 50 degree, warm the solution, not boiling, it is just warming and cool. Treated with 0.1 molar of perchloric acid using 0.05 ml of 1-naphthol benzene as indicator. We can use crystal violet also, or we can use 1-naphthol benzene indicator can be used. This is the procedure. And this is about calculation. Titer value, X represents titer value. This is equivalent weight factor. Already we have seen in the tabular column, the same you can write here. And normality, calculated normality. What normality you have obtained through standardization. After standardization, what is the normality? Exact normality of perchloric acid, then equivalent weight factor, then percentage to calculate percentage 100, then normality, given normality, that is 0.1, then weight of sample 0.25. Substituting all the values, you will get percentage purity of sodium benzoate. That is the estimation of sodium benzoate. Next, estimation of ephedrine hydrochloride by non-aqueous method. Here, same procedure of preparation of 0.1 normal perchloric acid is same. And this is attached with perchloric acid. So we need to add mercuric acetate, I think so. Definitely mercuric acetate must be added to eliminate chloride ions. And standardization also is same, similar to the last procedure, perchloric acid standardization using crystal violet as indicator. And primary standard is potassium acid tholate, potassium hydrogen tholate, that is. Then assay procedure for ephedrine hydrochloride is 0.17 gram ephedrine hydrochloride is dissolved in 10 ml mercuric acetate. So mercuric acetate will convert chloride ion to mercuric chloride, and acetate ion will be released. That acetate ion, by adding acetone, it will be converting acetonium. Acetonium ion will be forming by adding acetone. Acetone, when it is existed with acetic acid, it will be existing as acetonium ion, and this will be converting acetate ion to acetic acid. So only acetic acid will be there in the solution. 0.1 molar perchloric acid is used, and methyl orange in acetone is used as indicator. Here methyl orange is used as indicator. When methyl orange is not available, we can prefer crystal violet. When the mentioned indicators are not available, it can be treated with crystal violet itself. Okay, and the calculation part is same, titer value, normality, what normality of exact normality of perchloric acid, then equivalent weight factor, 1 ml consumes 0.02017 gram of ephedrine hydrochloride, then to calculate percentage 100, then exact normality, what a normality we expect, it is 0.1 normal, then weight of sample will be of 0.17 gram. This weight of sample 0.17 gram. So if you apply this in the calculation, you will get percentage purity of ephedrine hydrochloride. This is the scheme of titration of sodium benzoate. This is standardization. Okay, here both the side we are using, we can use crystal violet as indicator for standardization and assay. Naphthol benzene, 1-naphthol benzene has been mentioned in the procedure. If not available, crystal violet can be used. Solvent is acetic acid. What is the quantity and what is the titrant? What is the endpoint? Bluish green color, appearance of bluish green color will be the endpoint for crystal violet indicator. Here also crystal violet indicator can be used. Ephedrine hydrochloride, acetone is the solvent here to convert acetonium acetate ion to acetic acid. Acetone is used. Here a standardization is common like previous one. When we use crystal violet as indicator, appearance of bluish green color is the endpoint. Okay. So with this non-aqueous titration chapter gets completed. Okay. Is there any doubt in preparation of perchloric acid, in the classification of acidimetry and alkalimetry solvents? Is there any doubt you can ask now so that we could clarify it? The next week you will be having class test on unit 2. Okay, I will post you the questions. You have to write answers in the class test notebook with the cover. I already instructed how to maintain class test notebook. Write and upload the scanned copy of your test material. Okay, that I will assign tomorrow. Questions I will upload tomorrow. Okay. The next week, Friday only, I have planned for class test. So you can, you'll be having nearly 1 week for studying unit 2. And this unit 2 will be included in your first sessional exam. Acid-based titrations, both aqueous and non-aqueous, will be added for your first sessional. And next chapter, unit 3, precipitation titration will be started from next class. Okay, forthcoming class will be the precipitation titration. Okay, thank you all. Any doubts you can ask. So we'll stop the meeting.